Seriously. That's right. Despite the possible internal bleeding I'm currently suffering, I'm going to come here to call this IWS title match between these two IWS legends, so to speak.
I'm glad you're feeling well enough to be out here right now.
Retaining the title. Thank you very much, Kevin Steen. I will never make that mistake again. Introducing first, the challenger, from Tijuana, Mexico, weighing 189 pounds. He was the 2007 Comeback Wrestler of the Year. He is a current Ring of Honor superstar, a former PWG World Champion. He made his debut for Dragon Gate in Japan in July of last year. And he is undoubtedly the greatest high flyer in the history of the IWS. Ladies and gentlemen, the generic luchador, El Generico!
What an introduction for El Generico!
That's right. Quite an introduction indeed, detailing his all of the accolades of the generic luchador.
He didn't neglect to mention that he's a former IWS World Heavyweight Champion as well.
He didn't neglect to mention that.
He was the 2004, 2005, and 2006 Quebec Wrestler of the Year.
Came pretty close this year as well.
I believe so, yes.
Ring of Honor superstar.
As is Generico.
Also a former PWG champion, a title which he won a year and a half before El Generico. Kevin Steen is also a member of the Dragon's Gate roster, and he is without a doubt the most decorated and accomplished wrestler in IWS history.
More like Quebec
Ladies
history.
And gentlemen,
yeah, I'd say so.
IWS Heavyweight Champion, Mr. Wrestling, Kevin Steen.
Mr. Wrestling, Kevin Steen, two-time IWS World Heavyweight Champion, doesn't want that reign to end anytime soon.
That's correct, Mike Rotch, and he is facing his longtime rival, and I guess you can say there's a mutual respect between the two. They've been tag champs in the past all over the country, actually all over the continent, and these men know each other quite well. And undoubtedly, like you pointed out, probably the two biggest superstars to come out of Quebec in the last maybe 20 years.
And the referee calls for the bell.
And here we go, Mike Rotch.
It's underway. One-on-one encounter here for the IWS World Heavyweight title. Kevin Steen taking on El Generico. A matchup we haven't seen in quite some time here in the IWS.
That's right. I believe last time was at Hardcore Heat 2004 or 2005.
That was ages ago.
Yes, that's right. That was the show after. That was the show after Sid beat the crap out of me.
Hard punches.
Hard punches. Hard punches galore.
He's trying to break your heart.
Yes. And we'll stop talking about that right now. But the show after that, which I believe was Hardcore Heat, they had a pretty wild match where they brawled all over the spag and broke numerous tables.
And there was actually a package pile driver on the top rope.
There was a package pile driver on the top rope. I'm sure El Generico would very much not like that to happen again.
Single leg takedown by Kevin Steen, working on the ankle of El Generico while stomping on the wrist.
Like immobilizing the arm and now going down to the headlock.
On the mat. Jericho in a pinning combination.
Now these guys know each other quite well, but they're still going for they're feeling each other out here, trying to see with a slow starting off the slow pace. Sorry, using my words here.
As we mentioned, a one-on-one contest we haven't seen in quite some time. They have both evolved as wrestlers. They've changed quite a bit. So this feeling out process is definitely necessary.
That's right. And they are longtime rivals, but they have been tagging much more in recent memory than they have been facing each other. They've had all kinds of memorable matches in Ring of Honor. I believe they were
PWG Tag Team Champions at one point.
At one point, exactly. So I'm not sure exactly when their last singles match against one another took place.
And some people have taken to calling them Steenerico, a takeoff of the Hollywood couple thing, like Bennifer and whatnot. But I think that's very lame.
It is quite lame.
I refuse to refer to them as that. It's very homosexual. It also implies that they're dating in Hollywood.
It does, and I commend you for not acknowledging that name.
Generic, I'll be able to make it to the ropes right now. Kevin Steen had him locked in that front face lock.
That's right. And Kevin Steen, despite the mutual respect, Kevin, you can't forget Kevin Steen. He's got a rather large chip on his shoulder, nonetheless. And he knows he's top shit, and he knows how good he really is. And he's not afraid to let his opponent know just how good he is. And right now, he's letting El Generico know, just like how he let him know during the introduction, that everything Generico's achieved, Steen was able to achieve before he did.
Popping the elbow. And there it is. Got control of the wrist of Kevin Steen.
Nice reversal there.
To bring the arm. There we go. Arm ringer. There we go. Tippy toes to get all the leverage on that arm. Kevin Steen showing athleticism despite his gargantuan size.
That's right. Kevin Steen is a big, big man, but he is a very, very agile man despite his size. When I started wrestling school with Kevin about 6 or 7 years ago, he was smaller than I was. He was doing all those flips, and he can still do all those flips now, and he's like twice my size.
Wow. Listen, we got a standstill. The fans showing their appreciation for this match so far.
That's right. The fans all sitting quietly, sort of like a Japanese ambiance, all watching, waiting, expecting for whoever's going to take control of this match.
And you know what's going to happen. Kevin Steen admonishing a very annoying fan.
That's right.
And the fans saying that he's a big faggot in French.
That's right, for all you non-French speaking fans listening to us on DVD. And Kevin right back to the headlock once again. He's just wearing down that neck. Obstructed here. What's going on?
Oh,
brutal tackle there from Steen.
It's the ropes. Drop down by Generico. Leapfrog. Kevin Steen puts on the brakes. Big arm drag. Del Generico.
Nicely done. Oh, arm drag exchange.
Return in the favor. Ducks the clothesline. Look at this now. Full Nelson applied. Generico springboards off the ropes without that arm drag variation. Charging in on Steen. Steen cuts him off right there. Sensing doom, perhaps that Generico was coming for that big Yakuza kick.
That's right, the Yakuza kick that Kevin Steen has got kicked in the face with many, many, many times over the past few years. And now Generico outside, and now Steen appears to be, that my views, quite obstructed, just giving him a path back into the ring.
It's a show of respect here. As you mentioned, these guys, they traveled the roads together in recent years, a tag team everywhere.
I still don't know if I would trust them, though. But Kevin Steen lets him in the ring, didn't kick the ropes, didn't kick him in the balls. I guess Steen might respect him even more than I anticipated.
Well, he respects him enough to give him the first shot of his title.
How are you going
to
eat your taco?
Here we go. Circling the ring.
Oh, who gives a shit?
Hey, Kevin! Paying a little too much attention to these fans.
That's right, but that's part of his trademark. And now it's Generico now with his own headlock. That's right. And Steen now throwing him off the ropes. Let's see what's going to happen here.
Oh! Stands tall after that shoulder block attempt.
Deafening
shot. Nailed Generico with a chop that took him right off his feet. Generico looking for the back body drop. Steen telegraphs, sunset flip, but Generico rolls through. Flips over, big drop kick to the back of the head of Kevin Steen. Generico, lightning quick, hard to call. And we're going to do it.
That's right, we are going to do it, and we're going to do our best. But the trademark El Generico there takes him out with a drop kick to the face and drop kicks him to the back of the head.
The fans are chanting for Generico to dive. Look at this.
Oh, Generico's going to return the favor.
Whoa.
Show of respect there by Generico. Now how is Steen going to react to this? Oh,
man, look at this.
Slides under the ropes.
Well, this is very like Kevin Steen to make his own path. And who has carved his own path in the annals of professional wrestling, if you want to say it like that. You know, this man was once asked to leave the IWS in order to obtain a dark match with WWE, but chose to stay here.
That is correct.
And he actually used the words that he was going to choose his own path. and make his own path in professional wrestling.
And he did. And that path has led him all over Europe, all over Japan. I don't think he's gone south of the border to Mexico.
All over Generico's face with those big European uppercuts.
Pat is absolutely correct.
And another. Oh, man. I heard the impact of that one.
Almost knocked his mask right off.
Only a one count right now. Generico able to kick out. Generico wants this title.
That's right. The title that, as you pointed out before, Generico held, but he held for a good, what, 5.5 minutes perhaps?
That's right. He actually lost it to Kevin Steen. Maybe that is the one title that Generico did hold before Kevin Steen.
Yes, that is. He did hold it about 5 minutes before Kevin Steen.
What a sweet 5 minutes it was.
That's right. And he did beat PCO, which is no small feat.
Definitely not.
Oh, and it just punched him right in the jaw there.
The history between these two is just insane.
That's right. It's kind of like a love-hate thing, I guess you could say.
We can't even begin to call it out. Ducks the chop attempt. Fires away with a chop of his own. The fans calling for Generico to take the shirt off Steen. But before he could, Steen goes to the eyes.
Generico there. Played to the crowd just a bit too much. They're looking for a reaction. And got thumbed right in the eye by Steen. Now Steen, he's baiting him. He's calling him to get up.
Generico doesn't know where he is.
Apparently not. He's partially blinded.
Oh!
My lord.
Big chop. Right off his feet. The cover. Only a two count. Now look at this. Steen showing signs of frustration. Hammering away on the back of Generico.
Oh. I didn't mean this. You did.
Whipping Generico off. Telegraphs the back body drop, kick to the chest, ducks the clothesline, goes around the world, into the arm drag.
Almost
Generico.
That's right, almost lost him there, but ended up getting with the arm drag into
a leaping leg lariat right there.
That's right. Generico, oh, he's gonna fly.
Hopes open this time.
Big, oh my god!
Somersault dive over the top, and the fans are going wild.
I don't even know what to call that. He just flew right over the top rope.
Regla's abandoned right there. Just threw all his weight over that top rope onto Kevin Steen.
Come on, guys, get back in the ring. Come on.
I see Generico's up. I believe Kevin Steen's getting up also. I think that was a double axe handle over the back of the head there.
The action is on the opposite side of the ring. We can't see very much. See fans in front of us now. They're going back into the ring. Ooh, only a one count. Kevin Steen able to kick out.
And Generico's going back to work.
Elbow butt to the back of the neck.
It's like pointed the elbow right to the back of the neck there. Generico probably trying to soften him up for one of his various brain busters. He's probably going to be looked for. Perhaps his half Nelson suplex is probably trying to set him up for. Big forearm shot yet again. Absolutely correct. Every move is calculated. And that's why the guy has been so successful. And why he's gone to the race to the top or whatever that tournament was, and how he's been to the King of Europe and all those tournaments he's been in all over Europe.
Like right now, once again, focusing on the back of the neck. A second ago, kicking away at the midsection of Kevin Steen. Forced to drive all the air out of the lungs and diaphragm of Kevin Steen.
I don't know, but trying a body slam might not be the best idea against Kevin Steen.
Definitely not.
Not when you're El Generico anyways. Maybe if you're Jake
Kevin
Matthews
Steen's
or something.
And there it is! Generico with the scoop slam.
But how much did that possibly kick out of his back, though?
Ooh, only a two count. Generico with
the That's right, because Steen is, I don't know how much they announced him at. 250, 260?
I believe so, around that area. He's a very, very big man. Generico with a big forearm.
Generico, when he lacks in size, he makes more in intensity because all of his strikes, his boots, his elbows, whatever he may hit you with is going to be precise and it's going to be hard.
As we mentioned, they serve a purpose. Charges in.
Backdrops him on the apron there.
Oh, look at that. An exchange of forearms right there. Generico getting the better of it. He's on top now. Steen. Oh, looking to send Generico over, but sent off by Generico. Generico up top. Big crossbody and the cover. Only a two count.
Very close though. Right now he's getting the better of Steen. He's just been
beating into the punch. Come on, man. And once again, a hush is falling over this crowd.
That's right. They're not quite sure who to root for. They have basically Steen. Kane, who is the local hero here,
Oh, man. Steen was playing possum right there. Jericho was going for a split leg and moonsault. Steen.
Listen to those forearms right to the back.
Definitely quick up to his feet. Assaulting Jericho's back with his forearms.
Let's get back suplex from the top.
Jericho holding on for dear life. Hanging away at the face of Kevin Steen. Opening up big right hands.
Right to the nose there. What's Jericho going to do here?
Set him into the pillar!
Head
Holy shit!
Framing the pillar!
And my lord!
And oh my crotch, how the tide has turned! And what is Steen doing here? And we were talking about how Jericho is going to work on Steen's neck. Oh. I think it's Jericho's neck that's feeling worse for wear right now.
What did you think of that big post, bud? Did you like it?
I thought it was vicious.
What? Kevin Steen, I thought it was vicious. You want to see it again?
No, not again, not again. Head first into the post.
The pillar. The pillar that is holding up the beautiful roof at the gorgeous, luscious Bogies World here in East End, Montreal.
You know, I've seen a hole in the outer core of one of those pillars. It's solid steel burner in the middle.
That is correct, Mike Rock.
You realize that if you send him a knock hard enough and knock that thing over, we don't die.
That's right. And Bogey's World would be no more.
Come on, guys, get back.
We'd die, but it would be because we love wrestling.
Come to it back, yeah.
That's correct. We'd die for just
worth it.
And unfortunately, I have no clue what's going on.
I see a fan in front of us, so I'm going to drop the Lacour line with my best Lacour impression. You ready?
All right, good for him.
This match is brought to you by the CNIB, the Canadian National Institute for the Blind, because we can't see shit.
That's Lacour.
That is a beautiful Lacour imitation.
Shout out to Lacour. I love Lacour.
Yes. Big shout out to Lacour, he's my homeboy. And I think I heard some chops from here, so I'm going to be assuming Kevin Steen was the one giving them out.
I'm hearing flesh on flesh for sure. I just don't know whose flesh is getting whose flesh at this point.
Oh, wait, here's Kevin Steen. Steen appears to have returned to ringside. Oh, wait, there's Jericho. I think, yes, I can see his hand reaching over. And Steen appears to be big elbow shot. I guess he was playing possum.
Oh, man, once again.
First, right into the post this time.
Oh, we can actually save.
Yeah.
That guy's drunk.
Give me money.
He said after show, give me money.
Oh, cool.
I was about to use a cliche here and see if they were actually beating each other from pillar to post. Because they actually are beating each other from pillar to post. Only two.
Truer words are never spoken, Mike Rotch. And right now, Kevin Steen, who before was getting out high slide, out strike, and right
outclassed.
Outclassed basically, but right now he's in control. That's a big,
big elevation. What impact?
Only a two count though.
Oh, Steen hits the ropes. You know what it's time for here. Slows down.
Leg
drop.
Right to the back of the head.
And all the weight of Kevin Steen dropping.
Not only the weight, but the velocity of the flip, compounding the weight. And landing his leg right on the back of his head.
That's some science right there.
That is some science.
A squared plus B squared equals C squared.
If you say so.
That's a Pythagorean theorem. I remember that shit.
Don't choke, Steen. Come on.
Pythagorean theorem, but whatever.
It's something like that.
Regardless, we're not here to talk about isosceles triangles. We're here to talk about wrestling. And right now, Kevin Steen has El Generico in a side headlock, and he's just sucking the life and the air right out of him.
That's right, El Generico trying to rally the troops that are the hardcore soldiers here in attendance. But Kevin Steen maintaining control of the head. Generico attempting the elbow out. Breaking the grip of Kevin Steen ever so slowly. Hits the ropes. Steen!
Oh, schoolboy!
Was looking to cut him off with the knee lift. Was rolled up, ducks and clothesline, kick to the midsection. Steen now.
Oh!
Picture perfect neck breaker, center of the ring right there. Reminiscent of Ravishing Rick Rude.
Exactly what I was going to say, Mike Ross. Shades of Ravishing Rick Rude. May he rest in peace.
Only at Superman. Come on. Steen not able to get generic to stay down for a three count with that neck.
That's right. And now we were talking about before how the precision of El Generico, how he focuses. And now every move is calculated. Every move Kevin Steen is doing is calculated right now, and he's focusing on the neck. The neck that I'm amazed wasn't snapped when it hit that pillar. Oh, but wait, here comes a backbreaker.
Oh.
A tensor bandage hanging out the knee pad of Kevin Steen.
That's right. If there is a weakness Kevin Steen has, it is those knees. He's had multiple surgeries on...
I believe it was the left one last month, though.
That is correct. So it will be his... Achilles has always been his Achilles heel, so to speak. Perhaps one day there'll be an expression known as the Steen knee.
That'd be not cool.
No, definitely not. But
taking a swat in the face by Generico, firing back. Generico looking a little worse for wear at this point.
That's right, Generico trying to get up, trying to fight his way up, but he can barely stand. I mean, look at it. His legs look like they're made of rubber right now.
Big shot to the jaw, Kevin Steen. Big chop. Oh!
All right, big chop, and Steen appears to have hurt his hand there.
Oh! Big standing frog splash. Wow, Steen.
And Steen now visibly frustrated.
Oh, yeah. Big time frustrated. Kevin Steen.
Not too many people get thrown to pillars and then kick out later on.
Hey, he's unloaded almost everything he's got. Check that time. And Generico, not, you know, giving up.
That's right. I think Steen is going to have to upgrade to a higher move set, perhaps. Maybe go for a Steenalizer. Oh! Toss up into a dropkick. Beautifully done.
Oh, no. Steen's in that corner. Generico.
Can this be the Yakuza kick?
Oh, he's feeling it. Charges in. Oh, and Steen cuts him off with a big back.
Steen saw that coming.
Generico going to charge in again. Kick to the face right there. Kevin Steen.
Oh, Michinoku driver.
Is that going to be it? Oh, Steen able to get up the very last second.
That's right. Now, Generico, as you can see, still not, still a bit winded off from the beating that's been laid down on him. Didn't have very much on that cover. And wasn't able to put much pressure on the shoulders or use the legs for momentum. And didn't. Unfortunately, Steen was able to get out. Well, fortunately for Generico.
Now, both men on their feet exchanging forearms.
Oh, big forearm there. Right back at him there by Generico. Oh!
Steen is putting his weight behind those forearms. Throwing everything. Oh my god.
Oh, Generico down to one knee.
Hitting the ropes. Look at this. Pulled back by Generico. Blue Thunder!
Blue Thunder power bomb. This could be it!
Only a two count once again. Come on, Generico. Should we make a reference to Generico's toes in the Royal Blue Thunder?
We should.
Yeah.
It was cheesy. I also like to comment that his pants do not match his mask.
That's okay. We forgive him for it.
I forgive him for it.
Over the top. Steen on the apron. Goes for the shoulder tackle through.
Generico. What's this? Uh-oh.
Setting him up here. It's going to be vintage Generico.
Vintage Generico.
Springboard moonsault on the second.
That's right. I've been victim of that move on many occasions myself.
Ooh, only a two.
Only a two count there, and Generico is starting to wonder now. He might want to try to set him up on the top rope to get him the top rope brain buster. In the IWS and many all around the world.
Same could be said about Kevin Steen in the Pac-12.
This is correct. Oh! Appears to be setting him up for the Lucha DDT.
Oh, Steen puts on the brakes, slaps the hand away. He gets the girl. Now Steen, the wrist clutch, drops him neck first across the knee with that cradle breaker. Only a two count.
And how did Generico kick out of that? He dropped him directly onto his knee. And Steen is very frustrated now. He has been just pounding on Generico for the last maybe 10 minutes or so, and he just can't put him away.
Oh!
Speaking of moving the ring,
jeez,
I'm surprised they didn't break that the ring post right out of its holdings. Oh, what's this? What's this?
Through the ropes. DDT on the floor.
DDT on the floor. My lord, Mike Rock.
Right in front of us. Finally, we got the best seat in the house.
For once. It's about fucking
time. Come on, guys. Come on, guys.
And Cena is down. He got driven head first right to the floor here at Bogey's World. And now Generico throwing him back into the ring. What's he going to follow up with here to try to put him away? Calling to the crowd. Oh, wait, he's going to the top.
Perhaps looking for that big super fly style splash moves.
Right through. Cena's kind of low here, though. Let's see what he's going to do.
And there it is.
There it is. Super fly.
Oh, man. And Steen able to kick out.
That's a two confirmed by ref Backhead.
You gotta wonder how much more any of these guys have left in this match.
That's right. They've just been both men have just been giving it their all here.
Reaching almost their entire arsenal. Kick, bam, the Steenalizer, and the package pile driver.
That's correct.
Who's gonna hit what first?
And won't even that be enough? Because I think Generico, as much as you said, like we said before, he had a very short reign, didn't even last the show. I think he would like to actually be able to take that belt home.
The Yakuza rolls.
Oh, super kick.
Continue, Mr. Kamikaze.
Oh, Yakuza!
Right in front of us, holy shit! Half and half!
1,000 suplex! Wait, Steen, he's got fighting spirit! Another half and half! This could be it right here!
And he kicks out!
Somehow, some way, Kevin Steen got a shoulder up. And I, Mike Roch, am shocked.
My lord.
The bell ringer right next to me was poised. I could see him.
What a display of heart here by Kevin Steen. Generico unleashing everything right there.
That's right. Because Kevin Steen, he's got a lot of pride. He just won the belt for Manny last show, which was all of, what, 3 weeks ago?
That's right. Only 3 weeks ago.
So I'm pretty sure he would like to keep that new beautiful belt that is sitting right in front of him.
Oh, and look what he's hooking up here.
Uh-oh. Mr.
Wrestling. Looking for that brain buster. Mr. Wrestling. But all he's had taken out of him in this match, will he be able to get Steen up?
Reverse. No, Steen, here he goes. Package pile driver, here it comes.
Generico floats over. Oh, and Steen turns him inside out with the lariat. The cover hooks the leg. Oh, man. Generico able to kick out.
Not quite enough. And how did Steen able to reverse that brainbuster after taking those two vicious half Nelson suplex? Now what can he be setting him up for here? Moonsault? Swanton?
I haven't seen the moonsault in some time, but he has been known recently to use a huge frog splash.
Oh, could be the frog splash, could be the Swanton. Hell, he could even pull out a 450. He's got quite a lot of high-flying moves in his arsenal.
Oh my lord.
Oh, but here it comes. This could be it. This could be it right here, Mike Roch. I don't think anyone's ever kicked out of this.
Could he get Steen up for this? Do you actually think he could? Steen hammering away at the body.
Oh, big headbutt there.
Sends him off now. Generico in perfect position for a Swanton.
Swanton
gets the knees up.
Gets the knees up. My God, Mike Roch. Knees right to the back. Another Yakuza kick. Oh, my God. Kevin Steen. I hope Kevin Steen has is getting the IWS to give him dental insurance. Another one! Steen won't have any teeth left after this.
Oh my God, Kevin Steen.
It's a good
calling
thing
him on again.
Another one! It's a good thing he's got baby food at home because I think he's going to be applesauce for the next 2 weeks.
And it's over!
It's over!
A new champion!
Three Yakuza kicks and it's over. And I, Mike Roch, am shocked.